in the city of Hacienda Heights. It's Marty's Corner. Starring Marty Shields. And co-host Darlene Marcuzzi. I'm your announcer, Tony Ridley. On tonight's show, from the Hobby Connection, John Franco. Comedian Adryan Rockenbach. Singer-actor Tommy Sands. And musical guest Glen. And now, yes, that is an arrow in his pants, and he is happy to see you. Here's Marty!
Welcome to Marty's Corner as we come to you live, as always, from Channel 20 here in beautiful Hacienda Heights. How you all doing tonight? Come on! Yeah. Michael Jackson. Did you see it? Did you see Michael Jackson? One bad apple, that guy. Yeah, Michael Jackson. Boy, you know, I saw the interview. Kind of freaked me out, actually, Michael Jackson. And apparently he was saying that he wanted to live forever. You know, so I guess he wants to live forever, so I guess he wants to maybe put blankets over his grandkids and hang them off a balcony or something. I don't know. Crazy guy. Also in the news, I guess rock and roll producer Phil Spector, I guess, was charged with, I guess, killing a young lady in his home about a week ago over in Alhambra. And I guess the story is, apparently, he asked her to rate his current record, and she said she could dance to it and had a good bleed. Oh, okay.
Ooh. Whoa.
Actually, the evidence they found at the scene was that apparently she was killed by a wall of sound. 16 guitars in a triangle, that's right, yeah. Terrible, terrible. President Bill Clinton was in the news recently. I guess Bill Clinton was over at the Rolling Stones concert at the Spectrum a couple days ago. Apparently, Bill is not going to be running for any office because I guess he was inhaling. That's right. Backstage, yeah. Daredevil, the new movie with Ben Affleck, comes out, I guess, this coming Friday, Valentine's Day, Ben Affleck. And I guess his costume is like skin tight. In fact, it's so tight you can see J-Lo's fingerprints all over it. Anytime you want to play something, let me know. Okay. Also in the news, I guess Los Angeles Times just announced in a new census, apparently for the first time ever, last year, more Mexican babies were born in California than any other group of people in California. And now for the first time, we have more Mexicans here than in Mexico. That's right, huh? Yeah. Oh, they're booing me now. JAMA, the Journal of American Medical Association, announced that apparently after 40 years of research, they finally discovered that breast enlargements are not detrimental to women, although they do make men stiff. Oh, I see where the audience is going. Okay, huh? Right into the gutter. Nope. We have a good show for you in Marty's Corner. 79th, 80th show or something here? We start our 10th year in Marty's Corner, first year of 2003. Yeah, thank you, huh? Wow. Valentine's Day, again, is only about a week away on Friday. And of course, all the years we've had guests on that talk about Valentine's gifts for ladies. We're going to kind of change it up here on Marty's Corner tonight. We have a gentleman who's going to bring some gifts on for gentlemen. He's the owner of a very, very cool hobby shop in Whittier. The Hobby Connection, John Franco, is here tonight on the show. What? I'm Marty's Corner. A comedian makes his first appearance here. This gentleman plays all over the place. And he's been nice enough to come down on a Saturday night and do some very funny comedy for us. Our good friend Adryan Rockenbach is here tonight. Adryan! Yeah. 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 What? Yeah, a gentleman we've had on, I guess Glen was with us maybe about, I'm thinking 6-7 years ago. This gentleman is a member of the Rockabilly Hall of Fame over in Canton, Ohio, and he'll be doing a couple songs for us. Glen is here tonight on the show. Yeah. What? Yeah. Marty's Corner. And a very special guest joins us here on Marty's Corner. We've been trying to get this gentleman for about a year, and he's been nice enough to come down, and he'll be talking about not only his career, but maybe actually doing a couple songs for us. Singer-actor Tommy Sands is here on the show tonight. Tommy Sands. And as always, I can't do the show by myself. I have a lovely co-host who is again with us here. Can you please give a warm welcome to lovely and talented Darlene Marcuzzi? Darlene, come on. Hey, Darlene, how you doing? And actually, a special treat. Stop it. Special treat here on Marty's Corner. DJing tonight, of course, Leonardo. Leonardo, play something for us. Bob Adley. Let's go sit down. Come on, let's see. Come on. Very nice. And I didn't see his mouth move at all. Do you see that?
I like it when the mouth moves.
I bet you do. You're Valentine's coming up. Do you have a Valentine this year? You don't have Valentine's, do you, this year?
Not a guy. I mean, my nephew, he's 2.5. I'm in love with him right now.
I don't think that counts, though, I don't think.
No, it counts.
Does it really? Any kind of love is good any way you look at it, isn't it?
Yeah. Definitely.
What we're going to do here on Marty's Corner is kind of a public service announcement for all the gentlemen, ladies who are out there during Valentine's Day. Of course, when you're in a relationship, you realize that not everything you say is the truth. I mean, it's got a little bit of truth, and of course, you want to kind of, you know, just kind of fudge a little bit. And so what we're going to do is kind of give us a public service announcement, let people out there know what people really mean when they're in love. Music, please. Honey, I will always love you.
And your friends, and your sister, and the librarian.
And that blonde with the perky boobs, and oh yeah, that French chick too, if she'd only shave.
Who needs money when we have love, sweetheart?
Yeah, you think I'm going to work, you can guess again. No bread, no bed. You got that, Charlie?
I love you just the way you are.
Yeah. The way you are right now, I mean, with your mouth shut for a change. Jesus, you give me a headache.
I can never be angry with you.
No, honey, I could never be angry at you. You hit on my sister again, though, and murder is a distinct possibility. You better sleep with one eye open if you know what's good for you, Charlie.
Sure, your mom can live with us.
I mean, why not? Good help is hard to find.
You know, you were my first.
Yeah, my first since lunch. Oh, goody, goody, goody. Look at that, the pool boy's here. I gotta go.
Sex doesn't matter.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't matter with you. Hell, I go solo most of the time anyway.
You know, I really wouldn't mind a small wedding.
I mean, why would I, dear? Gee, after living with you, I'm kind of getting used to things that are small.
And that's our public service announcement here on Marty's Corner. Terrible, terrible.
Love makes you say crazy things.
Doesn't it, though? Our first guest here on Marty's Corner is a gentleman that I said at the beginning of the show. He owns a very cool hobby shop over in Whittier. And he's been nice enough to come down and talk about, again, some of the gifts that maybe guys want for Valentine's. What do you normally get for Valentine's? Like flowers, candies, that kind of thing? Or
Yeah, jewelry.
Jewelry is good. Money's good.
For me, for a girl?
Yeah, for you.
I would, let's see, my top five things, a massage, you know.
So like personal things that you actually want yourself,
for
huh?
me, like relaxing things.
It's all about you, you know? Isn't it?
On Valentine's Day,
it should
be about the one you love.
Should it be? It's all about money.
Definitely.
We have a gentleman, as I said before, he owns a very cool hobby shop over in Whittier, the Hobby Connection. Can you please give a warm welcome to John Franco? John, come on out. John! John, how you doing? John, you know Darlene. You know, come on over. You know Darlene. Have a seat right here. John, how you doing?
This is for your monologue.
Oh, is that right? It's going down. Tell us a little about the Hobby Connection. You're located in Whittier. Whereabouts?
I'm Whittier.
Okay.
And we're right in the center, 6732 Greenleaf.
How long have you been open over there now?
3 years. And actually, we'll probably be expanding in the next couple of years. So things are going good.
And you have like a one-stop shop. Everything, what kind of stuff do you sell down there?
We sell models. We have all the paints for the models. Everything that you want to fix them. RC cars, comic books, all kinds of neat stuff. Baseball cards, There's just tons of different things. Die-cast cars, a lot of corgi. I brought some. You might hand me these couple of things we can show.
Let's see what we got here.
Okay. Okay. Not the corgi, but most of you.
A monster
you couch. Won't remember this. Yeah, that
wait,
one.
Wait, really. Totally. I'm, yeah.
Okay, what are we looking at here?
This is the monster's coach.
Okay, let's take a look at it on camera.
Company called Ertl reissues this. Very cool. We've sold a lot of them.
Is this big, a lot of retro stuff, or probably just the monster car itself?
Okay, they do a lot of retro. They do
this
Speed
is
Racer.
Very cool.
They do older cars. And then there's one underneath. They also do the new cars, that Acura. It's down there a little bit.
Let's see.
What else we have?
This you is recognize
a,
this.
There we go. It's Ozzy, right?
Yeah.
From the Osborne, see that?
Oh. Yeah, we have a whole selection of
now,
toys, too.
Now, this actually, if I guess it makes a noise or talks or some crazy thing. Let me see if we can pick that
Let's
up.
Let's see if you can make it work.
One more time. Okay, boy, yeah. That's great. What else we got in there?
Star Trek.
Okay, yeah, and we also have Star Trek collectibles.
Okay.
All kinds of dolls, ships, models.
And these are big, I'm guessing, for Valentine's Day, guys are buying this or whatever.
Well, it depends what someone likes. You should know what your spouse likes.
You should,
most
but...
Most men like toys, right?
Well, you were saying that one of your boyfriends, you got him a toy or something for...
I did, for Christmas. What'd I got him a miniature monster truck, but he was just a jerk, so that's probably why I didn't like
okay,
that.
Fine, well... Okay.
We sell a lot of monster trucks.
Okay.
Uh-huh. I'm sure his
you're,
is doing
you're
well.
Bitter, aren't you? Okay.
Okay.
What are we looking at here?
This here is something that you might be seeing on the news soon or hearing about anyways. But besides older ships and
right.
planes, we sell all the newer ones too.
Are these real big though? I mean, a lot of people are buying
actually,
a lot of...
Actually, yes. You know why? They can make it. It's a really good hobby. And it takes away a lot of stress.
Are there probably guys that are like ex-Air Force guys
well,
that are buying this
yeah.
stuff?
Like, my dad would love something like this.
Yeah. Are most of the guys, are they older guys, younger guys? Who's coming into
no,
your shop?
No, actually, it's a lot of young kids, teenagers, older guys. Some girls, women build models.
Women build
models? Much bigger than you think, yeah.
I wouldn't have known that. We're looking at the
they're talented too.
Titanic.
That's right. You told
of course. I meant to say that.
He's blonde.
What? That has nothing to do with it at all. We're looking at the RMS Titanic, and this is great. This is huge.
Yeah.
This is Revell?
For the older crowd that might have a little trouble seeing, it's a big model the size of that box.
Easier to put together?
Yeah.
Let's bring something else. What do we else we got here? We got
right
tons
here.
Of
I'm
stuff.
I'm going to show you.
Okay.
This is the corgi line we carry. Everything.
Now, what is this called?
This is the corgi line.
Okay.
It's a collector's die-cast line.
Okay.
And this is the smallest piece you get, something like
$7.
$7? If you're on a low budget. And it goes up to pieces like this. It might be 20 or 30, all different eras, even buses, streetcars, new military, commercial
yeah,
airlines.
My nephew loves stuff like
yeah,
that.
All the way to $80, $90, that type of thing.
Look at what we got here.
Here's some of the comics.
Let me hold these up as you
very
talk about Liz.
This, by the way, is Daredevil number 2.
Okay.
This particular copy is in average shape, not real great.
So how much does that go for, an
average
shape?
This one I'm selling really inexpensively at $200.
Ooh.
You can see Ben Affleck right there on the cover.
Is that Ben?
Like I don't think he was born when that was published.
What else?
And there's a couple. We also do a lot with local artists.
Okay.
These are a couple books local artists do. And they're working on a lot of projects.
And these are guys from Whittier
stuff.
Or just primarily in the area here?
Yeah, Whittier, La Habra, anywhere in the area.
So you also support local artisans
always,
as far as that goes?
Always. If you're working on a local project, come and see me.
That's awesome.
Do you yes. buy, do you sell, do you trade the whole nine yards?
I do it all.
Okay. What else we got here? Okay, and we also have...
Heavy metal.
Yes.
Now, these are kind of graphic, aren't they, or something?
Well, these are older ones, but a lot of people don't know they still publish it. Actually... The guy who created Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles bought the company and publishes Heavy Metal now.
Also.
And so a lot of guys remember from their college years, that type of thing, and it would be a really neat, fun little thing, you know, maybe if you're going to dinner or something like that on Valentine's night to surprise him with.
That is cool.
Let's go pull some
and
more stuff
something
out of
you
there.
Can read together.
I would give that gift.
And you have cars, I guess.
Yeah, you want to hold those
yeah,
up?
Yeah, I don't really be able to get these on camera or not, but we got all kinds
basketball,
of...
football, baseball...
Can you get a shot of those or not? Yeah.
Yeah,
very nice. Okay. Let's get some more stuff. What's that big, huge thing? I'm okay, let's get this first.
Okay, and Robotech, too.
Robotech, okay.
See, they're bringing back all the 80s nostalgia stuff.
Okay.
So if your gentleman is from that time,
cool.
Here's Transformers.
Transformers
the
rock.
New stuff, all that.
You got any Transformer geeks in the audience?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Okay, here's Transformers.
And here is... an 18th scale diecast car.
That's what I'm going to get you, popular. Marty.
Oh, really great. Cool. How much are these going for?
Something like this is about $30.
About 30 bucks.
This is a very unique piece. You used to buy the normal ones. It's
right.
Boba Fett from Star Wars for about $7. This particular one has a variant. He doesn't have his full circles on his...
So there's a variation off it?
They're just slits. So this one is $50. Very hard to come by. So.
And this goes for like 50 bucks?
Yeah.
Okay, what else you got?
Nice present for a Star Wars.
Give it down over there. Who's laughing
yeah,
over there?
Coming oh, back.
I
He-Man.
Would make the He-Man. You could get me a He-Man for Valentine's
Day. He-Man?
Yeah,
is He-Man?
Like a He-Man?
He-Man rocks.
He-Man rocks?
Yeah.
And you have the rocket right there.
You also
we also
sell rockets.
Sell rockets. We sell so many things I can't remember.
What about the Incredible Hulk? Do you have
the Incredible Hulk? We have, yes.
Okay, let's make some more. We just got a couple
and
seconds.
And also,
here.
These are, okay, a couple models. We also carry racing. That's Dale Earnhardt.
Racing,
Jr.
Dale Earnhardt.
Popular.
You're not going to be able to see me. I'm
furious.
Stacking so much stuff
all
up here.
All the neat stuff. Look at this Robotech stuff.
Like
this one's
Christmas.
A model.
Yeah. Oh, we're just going
like,
through this stuff.
This is like a paint set.
It's like Christmas time here. Getting to lost. You sell paints also?
Yes, okay. And you can buy these individual, too. Any colors you need. We have racks and racks of paints, brushes,
Jeez.
All kinds of specialty.
Like
sandpaper.
That. Now, what is this here?
Now,
what was that?
This is a larger rocket when size matters.
Okay.
This one you blast way off.
Size matters? What did
okay.
you say?
And, okay. That was you.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is this one?
Yeah.
You get that one?
Yeah.
Are these that, safe? I mean, are
these,
kids buying these?
Don't
things?
Ask questions like that. We sell.
Okay, I'll just put this over
no,
here.
No, no,
give
they
me this.
Are. They are very safe.
Safe and sane. Sure they are. Okay. What else do we have? I'm sorry,
this
John.
This is a Mustang.
A Mustang?
Yeah.
Okay, Mustang is good. Let's get the real big one. See the big one right there? Yeah, grab
oh,
that thing.
Yes.
That's huge.
Yeah, that.
It weighs like a ton. It's real, I think. Hold on a second.
This is a special limited edition.
This is the last one we have for this segment. Geez, this thing is a ton.
It's their Area 51 set. They came out right before Christmas.
Because there was a train when the saucer
gone,
went down. Sure
them.
It was.
We have a couple left, and every year they're going to do one car to add on.
What's your phone number real quick if they want to get in contact
it's
with you?
562-789-8995.
Come here for John Franco from the Hobby Connection. Yeah. Stay right here, John. Stay right here. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Get away. Welcome back to Marty's Corner on a live Saturday night, I guess it is. And again, and we want to go and talk a little bit to our DJ here, Leonardo, if I could talk. Leonardo, met you over at a really cool dance club over in Ontario called the Peppermint Lounge. Well, you play there, what, Friday, Saturday nights, is that right?
Friday and Saturdays.
Now, also, you also have another club you play in Hollywood, which is the?
The 45 Club, which is in Hollywood.
Whereabouts, you know, in Hollywood exactly?
Vermont and Lexington.
And if anybody wants to get a hold of Leonardo for any kind of gigs, I guess, you have a website. What is that?
It's www.the45club.com.
Come here, Leonardo. He's doing a good job tonight. Grand Ole Records. He's the man. Okay, well, you got the website now. You can talk to him later.
Don't get jealous,
Marty. I'm not getting jealous. Very possessive. What would you hear every month on Marty's Corner? It's the top 11 list. Are you into self-help? Do you like doing the self-help thing, the tapes? Do you watch any shows that talk about self-help and becoming a better person?
Are you making a sarcastic comment?
No, not at all.
Oh,
not
okay.
to you. No, we're on TV. I wouldn't do that. What we have here, again, as I said before, self-help is really big now. And, of course, Dr. Phil is the new guy on ABC, Oprah's friend. And, of course, here on Marty's Corner, we want to go and tweak that a little bit. And the top 11 list on Marty's Corner, which is compiled by our home office in beautiful Baldwin Park. Anybody from Baldwin Park? No, not a soul.
My ex-boyfriend was from Baldwin.
Was he? Okay, great. Top 11 here in Marty's Corner. Top 11 comments guys would like Dr. Phil to say. Drum roll, please. Number 11. He's right. You are a whack bitch. Number 10. Honey, if you're so concerned about your money, get yourself a job, you lazy fat cow. Number 9 on the list. Number 9. You say you love him, but you can't get a boob job. Number 8 on the list. Number 8. The key to a healthy relationship is communication, but sugar, you better shut your pie hole. Number 7 on the list. If he wanted you to know he's an important collection was, he wouldn't have hit it. Now, would he? Number 6 on the list. Of course he's got another woman. Look at you. Number 5 on the list. Number 5. You know he's right, baby. You look fat in those culottes. Number 4 on the list. You never work things out unless you talk about your feelings. I must say, I'm feeling a little horny right now. Number 3 on the list. Number 3, darling, you're telling him size matters, but you're as goddamn big as a house. Number 2 on the list. I got your life partner right here. And the number 1 comment, Dr. Phil, like to say, sweet cheeks. If you're not putting out, you need to drive him to the titty bar.
Well,
cool.
Do you like Dr. Phil?
You know, he helped me out. I've been having a problem with rushing everywhere lately. And my sister, she's a stay-at-home mom, and she told me something that he said. If you tell yourself you have to be everywhere you go 15 minutes early, notice I was on time to the show, you'll get there on time, and it's worked. So I give him props.
Okay. We have a guest here in Marty's Corner. This gentleman is a lot funnier than we are. He's a comedian, and he's going to be doing some great comedy for you. Can you please give a warm welcome to Adryan Rockenbach? Come on, Adryan! Get it up, Adryan! Get it up! Oh, man.
Thank you, Marty. Good evening, everybody. I just got through the strangest breakup with my girlfriend. You see, thank you for caring. You see, we broke up because of political differences. As it turns out, I'm a hardcore Republican, but I found out that she is a hardcore whore. So we had political differences. Actually, I guess that's not even really a political party, is it? Is that even a political party? No, I'm referring to the Republicans. Is that even a... I guess maybe it is. Anyway, so what she was a socialist, and, actually, I shouldn't say she's a socialist, because I never heard her say she was a socialist. I just assumed, because it seems that she believed that her body belonged to the people. And I think that... Thank you for liking that one. So now that I'm single once again, I'm using my free time wisely, I think. I'd like to tell you that I'm working out more, reading more, and I am contributing my free time to charity. Thank you. I'd like to say that, but it's not true. I'm watching a whole lot more TV. And one of the shows I've been watching is Friends. Anybody like that show, The Friends there? Yes. They say that show's been going on for too long and is not particularly funny anymore. I couldn't disagree more. Actually, I think this season, the 39th season, is the best season, frankly. And funny? Why, it couldn't be more funny. I think that last week's episode, the one where Joey came home late from his prostate exam, and he found Chandler on the shuffleboard court had fallen and couldn't get up and broke a hip, I thought that was the funniest episode ever. And after that, the laughter ensued. Another show I'm enjoying is American Idol. How about you guys? Do you watch the show American Idol? Yes, for those of you who don't know, American Idol is a show where, it's a reality show where kids come and sing for 3 judges and they're trying to win a record contract. Last year's winner was Miss Kelly Clarkson. And I don't know about you guys, but she's my new idol. Just like the show tells you she should be. And I'll tell you something. Kelly is someone I should worship, even though the Bible says that thou shalt only have one God or one idol after me, something like that. But I'm worshiping Kelly. That's right. Because, of course, just like God, she doesn't answer my prayers either. But unlike God, she does have a record contract. So there, God. And that tells me one thing. That tells me that God doesn't have the balls to try out for Simon Cowell. You know who I'm talking about? Simon Cowell. He's the judge. He's the British ball buster there that everyone's afraid of because, well, he's honest. And I like that. I like Simon. He's cool. But I would wonder, what would some of today's celebrity vocalists have had to go through if they had had to audition for Simon? All right, Paula. All right, Randy. It says here that our next contestant is a man named Mr. Axel Rose. Says here that he is a singer of a Los Angeles-based rock band called Guns and Roses. Excuse me, pardon me. Oh, my bad. That would be Guns N Roses. What's the matter, Axel? Couldn't your band afford an ampersand? That was funny, wasn't it, Paula? They're so poor they couldn't afford an ampersand. No, it's not funny? Screw you, Paula! I swear, she's such a humorless little continuously annoying person. Anyway, Axel, and whenever you're ready, please proceed.
Ooh, I used to love her. Ooh, yeah, but I had to kill her. Ooh, and I can still hear her complain.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, Axel. Oh my God, Paula. Oh my God, Randy. Oh my God, Randy, Paula, Axel. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, Randy, Paula, Axel, Randy, Randy, Paula, Paula. Axel, I just wish that someone would love me enough to kill me so that I never have to hear you again. My name's Adryan Rockenbach. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. You know, Darlene.
Darlene.
Have a seat. Have a seat. How are you doing tonight?
Oh, well, you know, I've been having bad dreams lately.
I'm sorry you broke up with a girlfriend.
Oh! Did I mention that?
I'm sorry. We're a little bit short on time. You talked about the fact that you broke up with your girlfriend. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, she was... I don't know if I could handle the fact that she was a dominatrix. That's what she did for a living.
That's cool.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, constantly men coming over, and I didn't even know what a dominatrix was, Marty. Darlene, I didn't know what a dominatrix was.
You didn't?
She had to tell me about that, and she said that basically men pay her to step on their groin and, you know, say mean things to them. And basically, you get paid to be mean.
They need Dr. Phil.
Yes, that's true. They need Dr. Phil.
My God.
So, I mean, it turns out that they had to pay her to be mean, so I asked her, well, what do they do if you don't get paid?
Are
you forced to be nice? And she didn't say anything. She just kicked me in the balls.
And you're no longer with her anymore?
No.
I'm sorry to hear that.
No.
Sorry to hear that. Well, I'm glad you're wearing your cup on the show tonight. Is there a phone number or something if people want to reach you as far as playing any gigs? What's your phone number real quick?
Oh, well, sure. I mean, if you want to book me, I'll give you my number.
There
it's
you
310
go.
Area code.
Yep.
827-4722.
Come here again for Adryan. Welcome back. Stay right here, Adryan. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Take it away. Welcome back to the show here on Live Saturday Night on Marty's Corner. As I said at the beginning of the show, we have a gentleman who's been nice enough to come down. We've been trying to get this gentleman on our show for, I'm guessing, about a year. Again, a big celebrity in the late 50s, early 60s, a teen idol, and he's been nice enough to come down. Can you please welcome Tommy Sands and his Dr. Jessica? Come on out! Come on! Nice to meet you, Mimo. Tommy, how you doing? Have a seat right here, Tommy. See you right here, Tommy. Tommy, come on! Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome, Tommy. How are you doing today?
Fine. How about you, Marty?
I'm doing great. Thanks for coming down. Like I said, we've been trying to get you for about a year. We're so glad you fit us into your schedule. I got so many darn questions, and I want to get to them so we don't lose any time with you. I know that time is out of the essence. Were you primarily a singer who acted? Is that where it came from? Were you primarily a singer initially?
Yeah, I was a singer originally.
And you are you born here in California? Where are you actually from?
No,
originally?
I'm from Chicago, but I was raised in Houston, Texas.
Okay.
And I got my break in Houston when Colonel Tom Parker came into a club that I was playing when I was a little boy and discovered me and signed me up.
What year was that? Were you early 50s, mid-50s?
Early 50s, early 50s? Yeah. Yeah, I was a little boy. I was about 12 years old.
And then you came out to California soon after that when you got signed with...
No, I stayed in Houston and... then I came out to California when I was 18.
Okay, so we're talking what, mid-50s, early-50s, mid-50s-ish?
Mid-50s, yeah.
And you got right, did you start singing
57.
Right, 57, uh-huh. Did you start singing right away with what label were you on early then?
Was it? I was on Capitol.
Capitol?
Yeah, I got signed to Capitol when I was 18.
Well, that's great. And when did the acting come in? Was it right after that when you started getting the...
Right after that, Colonel Tom Parker had managed Elvis Presley.
Okay, right.
And Kraft Theater had written a show for Elvis, and Elvis was too busy doing movies, and so they asked Colonel if he knew anybody else, and he flew me out to New York to audition for the show, and I got it. And that was called The Singing Idol, and that was my first TV show.
And that was what, we're talking like mid-50s, late-50s?
That was 1957.
Where did the movies come from? I know you did a lot of movies. In fact, let's show some clips.
Sure.
We got some pictures. We got so many darn pictures. Let's bring them up here first. I want to show... let's show Mardi Gras. How many movies did you actually end up doing total?
Oh, I think about 15.
15 total?
Uh-huh.
And Mardi Gras, like an army movie? Is that what we're looking at here?
That was a VMI, about VMI Military Academy.
And you're one of the stars there?
Yeah, Pat Boone, Gary Crosby, myself, Sherry North.
And that's a nice shot. Let me put these up here, because I'm just... Who is this gal? Who's the gal here?
That's Molly B. That was my first girlfriend out here.
Is that right?
Yeah.
She's hot. I like this. We have a picture here with Fabian, I guess. And who's the young lady in the middle? Do you know who that is?
Toby Michaels.
Okay.
That was from a film called Love in a Goldfish Bowl.
I've seen this movie. Yes, I have.
Yeah.
That was a good movie. Let's see what I got. So many of these darn pictures. I want to show the picture. Well, let's just go into this. We're looking at Frank Sinatra.
Frank Sinatra and me in a picture called None But the Brave.
Tell me about the Sinatras. What were the Sinatras like?
Well, Frank Sinatra was very kind to me.
Was he?
Yeah, I was married to his daughter Nancy for about 5 years, and he was always very, very nice to me. I liked Frank a lot.
How'd you meet Nancy?
She came to one of my shows at the Coconut Grove in Los Angeles, and she came backstage afterwards. And we met back there, and we started going out with each other. And about a year later, we were married.
Well, I think that I want to show some other stuff. I want you. We also, in fact, we have some video clip. Can we roll that videotape in the studio here? You've been nice enough to bring down some clips of the movies you're in. Let's take a look right over here. And if we get the volume up here, okay. Oh, don't nobody move. There we go. Bingo. Okay, turn the TV on. At right now. This is you dancing with
Annette Funicello.
And this is
Babes
from,
in Toilet.
This is Babes in Toilet.
Yeah. It took me about 6 months to learn that dance.
Are you not a dancer by trade?
I am not a dancer.
You look great though. I mean, you fooled me. It was great. And this was one of your first movies, I'm guessing, Babes in Toyland?
Babes in Toyland was in 1962. My first movie was 1957, Sing Boy Sing.
In fact, we have a clip of that. Can we go ahead and roll the clip of Sing Boy Click? They're going to go ahead and bring that up on the monitor of Sing Boy Sing. And, of course, we also have a still of it here as we're bringing that up in the control room. There he is. All right. All right. It's great. Yeah.
My birdies put in my heart. my song. I'm gonna walk, walk and talk, my love.
This is a movie about a young kid who makes it big. Is that what this movie's about? Sing Boy Sing?
Right, right. That was the movie version of The Singing Idol.
Oh, is that what it was?
Yeah.
So this is where that one was?
Yeah.
That was great. I don't know if we got that on camera. We got a picture of this is a movie poster for Sing Boy Sing. Right there, and there you are in lovely color. Ed O'Brien, who else is in that
movie? Edmund O'Brien. Nick Adams, the late Nick Adams.
Right.
And John McIntyre.
Wow. You've got so many. I want to take one more look. We need to go to commercial break real quick, but let's take a look at this. This is a issue of Photo Play. And I'm guessing, God, I don't know what year this is. What year would you guess?
That looks like it's about 1957.
57? There you are. There you are. Right there. 57. I know we need to go for a quick break, but we're going to come back with Tommy Sands and Jessica. We're here for Tommy Sands and Jessica one time. Yeah. We're going to wait for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Marty's Corner. And what were we listening to? That was you, Tommy, wasn't it? What song was that?
That was called Ring-a-Ding-Ding.
Ring-a-Ding-Ding. Great song. We have some albums here that you've been nice enough to bring down. We have Steady Date with Tommy Sands. We get a shot of that.
That was my first album.
This is your first album?
Uh-huh.
Snapping right there. Look at that. Snapping, huh? let me show you another quick one real quick here. I like this one here. This is Sands at the Sands, which I thought was a great title. And who are all these beautiful young ladies?
The Corrines of the Sands Hotel.
Oh, yeah, huh? Hey, look at those gals.
Tough job, but somebody...
I would say so. did you date a lot when you were younger? I mean, did you get a lot of starlets, Tommy? I mean, you can tell me. No one's watching.
I was pretty bashful, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah, about the only time I went out is if a girl came up and asked me to go out.
You're kidding. As big as you were?
I was very bashful.
Oh, man, I would have just picked that up. Jessica, we talked briefly. You've been singing now for how many years?
8. And professionally.
Professionally? Mm-hmm. And what do you got going? How's your career going?
It's going really great. I've sung in a few different cover bands around town. The Candies. You can come see us in Hermosa Beach every Thursday night at the Lighthouse. I sing with another band called Platinum Groove. We sing up and down the coast. But I'm working on my originals, where I'm playing piano and co-writing all of the stuff and shopping for a deal next month. I had a deal about 2 years ago with RCA New York. So
we also have a gentleman who's come down. I guess he's a friend of both me and Tommy's, and he's going to be doing a song for us. Again, this gentleman is a member of the Rockabilly Hall of Fame. Can you please give a warm welcome to Glen? Glen, come on out! Yeah, Glen!
Thank you, Marty. Thank you very much.
Yep.
This is my little band here. They're going to start my song off called One Cup of Coffee. It goes like this. Well, one cup of coffee and a cigarette, waiting on the one I want to love and pet. Seems like a year since I've seen her face. Sweet lips I can't wait to taste. Waiting on my baby, but she ain't here yet. One cup of coffee and a cigarette. Don't show up, tears are gonna fall in the coffee cup. Cigarette smoke's getting in my eye. That ain't the reason that I cry. Waiting on my baby, but you ain't here yet. One cup of coffee and a cigarette. Start right here on the bass pedal. coffee and a cigarette. Just one more time on guitar. Well, one cup of coffee and a cigarette. Waiting on the one I want to love and pet. It seems like a year since I've seen her face. Those sweet lips I can't wait. Waiting on my baby, but she ain't here yet. One cup of coffee and a cigarette.
Oh! Hey, right here, Glen. Come on over, Glen. Glen!
Thank you.
Glen on a Saturday night. Welcome back to the show, Glen. It's been a while. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. I'm glad to be back here, Marty.
Have you been playing a lot? You've been doing a lot of gigs lately?
Well, me and Tommy's played 4 gigs together since New Year's. So we're playing quite a bit.
You have anything coming up real soon?
Yeah, I've got some things coming up. I'll be in Vegas over the Easter holiday at the Gold Coast Hotel. Be there Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night in Las Vegas, and we've got some other gigs coming up.
You mentioned the guys behind you. Let's go real quick. Who we have on Doghouse Bass back here? Doghouse Bass?
That's Russell Scott.
Russell, thank you so much. Thanks for going on, Russell. Yeah. And back on drums?
That's Philippe, my drummer.
Philippe, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And on guitar?
This is Skip Heller over here on the guitar.
Skip, thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
And Russell Scott's got probably the best rockabilly band there is in California. Russell Scott's in the Red Hots.
Outstanding. I said, Tommy's been coming down to the show tonight, and I guess him and Jessica are going to be doing a song for us. So let's go ahead and have you step off here. Glen, okay. One time. Glen, right? Glen. We'd like to bring on Tommy Sands, Jessica, Jennifer. Come on. Come on over. Go right ahead. Tear it up. Tear it up, guys. Tear it up.
All right.
I just got played off in D2. Sorry. It's alright. Maybe it's live TV. Close enough.
All right, there we go.
Call it a teenage crush. They don't know how I feel. They call it a teenage crush. They can't believe this is real. They've forgotten when they were young and the way they tried to be free. All they say is this young generation. Say I'm trying to rush. Please don't try to keep us apart. Don't call it a teenage crush. They forgot what say is this young generation is just not the way it used to be. I know that I know my own heart. You say I'm trying to rush. Please don't try to keep us apart.
Thank you.
All the guys are all around and can't you see she's in demand? I guess you see why I'm the worrying kind. I date her once, twice, and then I get to thinking she's nice. And then we get to kissing, ooh, gee, just think what I've been missing. Now that I'm finally going out of my mind, and though I worry about my baby, no, look, she's been running round. Don't wanna show her I'm the worrying kind. Oh, once I find a way that I can finally tame it down, then I'll no longer be the worrying kind. I get to thinking she's nice, and then we get to kissing, ooh, gee, just think what I've been missing. Now that I found her going out of my mind, although I worry about my baby, oh, she's been running out, don't want to show her I'm the worrying kind. I want to find a way that I can finally tame her down, and I'll no longer be the worrying kind. Then I'll no longer be the worry. Then I'll no longer be the
worry.
Thank you, sir.
Marty.
Jessica, thank you so much. Jennifer, thank you so much. Stay right here. Stay right here. We'd like to do a special presentation right now. If Glen would come back up. Glen, come on back up. Glen, yeah. Glen, come on up. Glen, woo! Where are you, Glen? Woo! Glen, come on up over there. There you go, sir. Come on in, Darlene. Come on, Glen. Glen, on behalf of Marty's Corner, we want to go and present you with two gold records. Can we look at a shot of that, please? Two gold records for Glen. Glen, one arm each, I guess. Here we go. There we go. And there's right there. Can we get that on camera somewhere? Okay. And these, of course, from the good friends over at Gold Legend Records. So we want to thank you for that. Thank you, Glen.
Well, thank you.
Let's set those over there real quick and go get the other ones real quick. And we're not done yet. Come on in, Pat. Pat from Legend Gold Records. Thank you, Pat, for coming down.
Thank you, Pat.
Thank you so much. And lastly, we want to go and present Tommy. Pat, you want to hold those Tommies? Your two gold records for Tommy Sands? Woo! Get a shot of that.
Thank you.
Outstanding. Okay. And again, we want to thank Tommy and everyone for coming down.
All right. Thank you, Marty.
We want to again thank everybody for coming down. And okay, well, let's take those out of your way real quick. And we need to go away. Darlene, you want to take those real quick? Take those out of the way. Thank you so much. Again, we want to thank you everybody for being here on Marty's Corner. Again, we want to have you join us next time on Marty's Corner. We want to thank all of our guests. First of all, the gentleman from the Hobby Connection, of course, John Franco. John Franco, ladies and gentlemen. Where are we at, John? Our good friend, comedian, Adryan Rockenbach. Adryan! Of course, a member of the Rockabilly Hall of Fame, our good friend, Glen, there you are, Glen! Thank you. And of course, last but not least, of course, our good friend, Tommy Sands, Jessica, and Jennifer, the guys in the band. How you doing? We got him on the phone. We'll see you next time on Marty's Corner. Leonardo, play us something out, everybody. Come on out. Come on.
Times don't want to go mad. Now many is the time I've seen a most attractive young Korean. But if I look, it makes my agent sad. But ooh, 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 I want to be bad. I want to go wild sometimes. I want to go wild. I'm tired of acting like an innocent child. Now many is the passing skirt and makes me sigh until I hurt. But if I touch it, gets my lawyer eye. But ooh, I wanna go wild. Now look away, tax consultant. Yeah, there are some things you better not know. Look away, little lawyer. Set me free and let me go. I wanna be rough sometimes, I wanna be rough. I'm tired of all this sweet and innocent stuff. Now after I've hit a note or two, I'd like to sew an ode or two. Live the kind of life I never had. I wanna go wild, I wanna be rough.